Hello, crafty friends. I have a new project share for you. Sorry, I've been MIA for the past few days, but I have been working really hard on creating this little folio for you. Actually, it's not a little folio. This is a large sugar plums folio for you, and I'm really happy to be sharing this with you. So, as you all know, and I'm sure you've seen this, this is the Sugar Plums Recollections paper collection. You get 24 designs. And although I feel that four of the papers are unusable, and the reason why I say that is because you can't use them in this album, and even if I were doing a layout, it would be covering up the words. So I most likely would not be using that. Although I wish I had cut out the mug, but I that was an afterthought. But anyway, let me go ahead and show you some of the dies that I used real quick in case you have any questions and I forget to tell you. So, because we all know I'm ADD. But anyway, so all of these are Chaos Craft dies. So this first one is the Layering Slimline tag die. And I really love how it has a lot of different toppers for you. And I'll show you a couple of those when we get into it. I also use the Peppermint Candy Shaker dies, although I only made one and I didn't actually turn it into a shaker this time. For this one, I used the new Christmas present paper die, and this one I thought was really fun because it has the bow and it also has Naughty or Nice and some little elements like Christmas trees and bells. So I thought that was really super cute. And then also one of my favorite tag dies in the whole entire world is the two large tag dies, and I just love the shape of them. It's like a little cloud bubble. So cute. Anyway, I'm gonna put these to the side real quick and let's get on to my little mini album. I really had a lot of fun making this. Actually, I created so many designs I didn't actually create the designs, but I picked out so many designs and cut them out on Cricut. I kind of went gaga. So anyway, you'll see in just a minute what I'm talking about. So first of all, this album is 9.5 by 9.5. Okay. And the reason why I call this a folio is because it is under 2 inches on the spine. Okay, so in my opinion, I feel that if the spine is not even 2 inches, it's more or less a folio, but this is a big folio and there's a lot going on. So first of all, I cut this cute little snow globe out on my Cricut, and I love that I turned it into a shaker. These little snowflakes came from the ornament section at Hobby Lobby that I went and got these like 4 years ago. And then I used some of these cute little tinsel pom-poms on here. This is a bow from Cricut, and actually right now these are free. There's a double bow and a single bow, and right now this is one of my favorite bows. It almost reminds me of the Minnie Mouse bow, so that's why I really like it. Then I created several sentiment PNGs. And my first one was Let It Snow, and I used rose gold foil. And thank you, Tiffany McGill, Crafting Like a Boss, for the gold foil. I can't thank you enough. I've been using it like crazy. So here I did the word believe, and I don't know if you can really see that, but I did use some Mod Podge and glitter on any of the blue ones that I did. So I just wanted to point that out. And then of course the back is the same as the front, just without all the fun little stuff on here. So let's get on into it. I just want to let you know that I know you can hold well over 100 photos, even with there only being 3 signatures. I'm letting you know that right now. What I mean by signatures is several pages in one signature. I don't know what else to call it. But anyway, okay, so we open this up and this holds 21 photos. So it holds 24x6 and then a larger 4x5. And here's another word that I cut out, Christmas Eve. And I'm gonna go ahead and just tie this up really quick. And here is another Cricut pattern. I really love these little cute mittens. And again, I turn it into like another shaker, and it holds two little 4x4 photos. Here is that slimline tag. And again, here is the one of the little tag toppers, which is like a doily. So cute, love that. And then again, here's that large tag die. Do you see what I'm talking about? The little cloud puff. I think it's so cute. Again, I got these from Tuesday Morning, and any of the jemmies came from my Halloween Michaels. I'm loving them. So you open, all the tabs are, again, from the Cricut patterns. Okay, so you open this up here, and you can hold a large photo here, and I put Christmas Mass because, you know, on Christmas Eve, we go to Christmas Mass, and so I decided to do a large photo for my family. And I know that only a portion of our family is coming, so that's why I created a smaller album, but it does still hold a lot of photos. I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to fill it all, but anyway, again, I love this little Christmas town. It kind of reminds me of like the church and stuff like that. Love this. And then I created a large pocket. Again, you can hold those 6x6 cut aparts that come from the collection. And then this is also a policy envelope that was really cute that actually goes with this little card right here. Isn't that cute? Okay, so in the policy envelope, I thought if I had any little tickets or anything that we might go to, I would put it in here. You never know. And then again, here's one of the sentiments from the collection, Christmas Wishes. And all of these three signatures have a very large mat, double-sided mat. And then this one has two pockets. Okay, so you can have a 4x5 photo on here. And here's where I cut out Christmas dinner. Well, this is actually Christmas Eve dinner, but... and then here's the present die. Is that not cute? I'm loving this. I will have all the links for all these dies down below if they are available. But I do know that you can also get them at Ali, but I'm impatient. I get everything at Amazon. I cut out one of the little Christmas cookies, and then I added on Renee Bouquet's little, she calls this cotton candy, and she just calls this candy. I don't know. They're so cute. So I added those on there, and again, we have a magnet, and it opens up into where you can either put two 4x6s or another large 5x7, and then again, you can put several photos on here, depending if you do 4x4s, or you can do two 4x6, 5x7, whatever you want to do. I have some journaling tags here, and then here's another one of the Cricut cuts, this little film strip. Okay, everything I have sized and saved for you, and I will try to find out if I can share those with you, according to my friend Jennifer Ford, who goes by Cat. She told me that it is possible, so I will definitely find out for you. As far as the sentiment PNGs, I will have a package that you can purchase, and it won't be much. It's just, you know, for my time, and you'll just have to email me and let me know you want them, and then I can send you a PayPal invoice. So anyway, you can have, you know, a large 4x6, one to have some vertical and horizontal photos on here. Again, that's where I use that Christmas wreath, and I just kind of try to center it as much as possible. Have a little magnet here. I love this little pocket. Again, it opens up. You have another large area to put photos. I also put Be Merry. Here's another Cricut cut right here. And this is from Capa Rouge Sketch. I just kind of thought this was really cute. I love the little coffee mug. And right here, we have another little cut from Cricut. I love the little snowman tag. Is that not cute? And again, we have more of the cut aparts. And oops, also another one of the film strip Cricut cut aparts. Okay. And then, of course, we have another large mat. And then it goes on to this one. And again, this was another Cricut cut. This is a little snow mountain. And let me see if I can kind of get in here. So you have some of your cut aparts, and I made these two large pockets. Another slimline tag. And again, see, here's another one of the different patterns. And also there's the little peppermint candy. So we also have, and I forgot to mention, this die was sent to me by Deborah Adams, Creative Life by Deborah. And so I went ahead and cut some of these out. Again, here's another one of the sentiments I made, Joy. And here is, you know, Christmas breakfast. And I believe she got this from either Amazon or Ally. So it is a really cute little die. I love it. And I use it quite often. Again, here's another one of the snowflakes. This opens up. And then I put the sentiment bagels because we always have bagels Christmas morning. And then I want to have some photos for Christmas breakfast. So I figured I could have quite a few in here. I also created the word brunch. So if you all have brunch, I did create that word, but I just didn't use it in my collection. Again, another mat. And then here, I thought it'd be fun to do something a little bit different. We have this little twisty guy here. And for some reason, he wants to get stuck. Okay. Hold on. I'm a dummy. Okay. I was turning it the wrong way. Okay. Anyway, well, we have a little magnet here to hold these little guys in. Okay. And here's some little of the cut aparts. Again, journaling tags. And then it opens up into two areas where you can put photos. Okay, and then it just closes again like this. And it has a magnet. And also I put some of these little frames. Again, these are Cricut cut aparts. And like I said, I saved everything to be able to fit into this album. So you should have no problems if you create this album with the directions, but the sentiments, you can resize those to whatever you want to. I'm just letting you know that I created it so that you could do that. And here's another one of the Cricut borders. I love the hearts right here. And then again, another large pocket to put a lot of photos in here. And I'm probably going to create more mats. I would have done a lot more decorating, but I haven't put the photos in yet. I plan on using a lot more of the Cap Rouge little things here. She has some deers and stuff like that, and I like to cut them all out and use them. So here is another waterfall. This one has peace on here. And again, you can put, you know, this should be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. 14, 16, 18, 20, 20, 22, 23 photos on this one. Okay. I decided to leave out the little, five by four or four by five, and add in a couple more spots to do four by sixes. But anyway, that is the end of the album. I hope you all like it. And just give me a couple days and the tutorial will be out. Also, I will have a PDF available. And again, the PDF will be available for purchase. Again, that is for my time for, you know, writing all the measurements down and typing everything up for you. So anyway, it won't be costly. It's just, you know, to kind of help me out so I can buy some more supplies like glue, tape, magnets, etc. But anyway, I hope you all have a wonderful and fabulous day, guys. Thank you so much. And I hope you all have a wonderful and fabulous Sunday tomorrow. Bye-bye, guys.